exhale, open your eyes and look through the bottoms of your eye sockets. Just a gentle gaze out the bottom of the eye sockets. And as you inhale, sweep the eyes directly up towards the upper eye sockets, so you're looking at the tops of the eyes. And exhale, take the eyes down, so they're looking at the bottoms of the eye sockets. And as you inhale, sweep them up. And one more exhalation takes them down. With the exhalation, so you're looking at the bottoms, and then you let the eyes just close, and you rest, and moisturize the eyes again. Next, while your eyes are closed, take your eyeballs so they would be looking out the right side of your eye sockets. And then open your eyes so your eyes are really looking out the right sides. Gentle gaze. Exhale fully. And as you inhale, sweep them towards the front of the room so they're looking straight out. And then on exhalation, take the eyes over to the left side of the eye socket. And as you inhale, sweep them back to the front. As you exhale, take them over to the right. As you inhale, sweep them to the front. As you exhale, sweep them to the left. As you inhale, sweep them to the front. And as you exhale, sweep the eyes out to the right again. And then close your eyes and let your eyes just relax so you moisturize your eyes. Good. Okay. Now we will continue with our head and neck exercises. So what we're doing is we're doing head and neck practices as part of the joints and glands exercise regime. And we have various components to the practice. We have self-massage. We did a little bit of that on Monday, the Abhyanga. Today we're doing Smriti. Smriti, that word S-M-R with a little dot under it, T-I, which means self-possession. And so far we've done exercises 1 and 2 of the head and neck, and we've done lion pose, and we just did a couple of eye exercises, all for better digestion. So we continue now, letting the arms dangle, and this time we'll rotate the head. So on an exhalation, on your exhalation, rotate your head and your chin to look over your right shoulder as you exhale. And as you inhale, bring the head back to center, sweeping with your breath. Your gaze is soft. And as you exhale, you take your head over to look over your left shoulder. And as you inhale, come back to center. Exhale, go to the right. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, go to the left. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, take the head to the right. Center. You exhale, take the head. back to center. And place your hands on your legs, close your eyes, and just let yourself absorb the experience. With reference to the body, Kaya, observe the body, Kaya, energetic, conscious, self-possessed, having eliminated both desire and aversion to the world. Now we continue with some exercises for the hands and the arms, letting your eyes open. Bring your awareness into your hands and your arms, and with an inhalation, float them up to the shoulder position, elbows just nicely bent. Relax the shoulders. And again, with the exhalation, let the hands fold a little more deeply at the wrists. And on the inhalation, open these up. Your palms are facing me. Good. Exhale down. Inhale, come up. Exhale, make a circle to the right. Exhaling down the right side of the circle. Inhaling up the left. Exhale down the left. Palms together with an exhalation. Inhale, stretch forward like you're going to dive, letting your head bow forward. And then as you exhale, bring your fingertips towards your sternum, towards your chest, folding your elbows to either side. And then inhale, open your arms up in a large embracing movement. Shoulder blades arrive on the back. As you exhale, you bring the fingertips in towards one another and your sternum folding in. And then as you inhale, come out as you're going to dive. As you exhale, bring the fingertips in, folding the elbows. And as you inhale, open. As you exhale, fold in. As you inhale, come into your diving position. As you exhale, fold the elbows, bring these fingertips in. As you inhale, open. And this time as you exhale, just lower the arms beside your chair. Just make some circles with the shoulders. Bringing the shoulders fully forward, up towards the ears, onto the back, sliding down the back. Reverse that direction. Bring the arms to a resting position. And just swirl your fingers beside your chair. Fingers in your wrists. Few times, both directions. Hold your hands and your palms as though you were holding some soup bowls. Hold in your little fingers, your ring fingers, second finger, first finger, thumb, and make a fist. Squeeze tight and hold. Squeeze. Squeeze your forearms, your elbows, your upper arms, shoulders. Squinch your face towards your nose, your eyes, your cheeks, and your lips. Keep holding the squinch and keep breathing. Squinch your neck, your torso, your abdomen, your buttocks, your upper legs, knees, lower legs, feet. Squinch everything. Hold it. Keep breathing. And release. Put the arms down. Let the eyes close and breathe. direction. Inhale as you come up. Exhale as you go down. And set that leg down. Let your inhalation lengthen your spine. Bring your awareness into the left leg. Float it up. On an exhalation, begin to make a circle down to the right with the foot at the ankle. Inhale, up the left. Exhale, down to the right. Inhale, up to the left. Exhale, down to the right. Inhale, up to the left. Good, set that leg down. The inhalation lengthen your spine. Bring your awareness into your right leg, float it up, and point your toe. And on an exhalation, take the toe in a circle down and out to the right. And as you inhale, in and up to the left. Exhale, down and out to the right. Inhale, up to the left. Exhale, down to the right. Inhale, up to the left. Good. Set that leg down. It's a lot to do like that, in that type of movement. This is the first time. We've been preparing for this for 5 years now. We've all been practicing together for 5 years. And just today, after 5 years of practicing 3 times a week, we're getting to the point now where we can hold the leg like that. It's pretty awesome. So give yourself some credit for that. That was really good. And just sit tall for a moment. Breathe. And bring the awareness into the left leg and float it up. And point the toe. And on an exhalation, take that toe out to the left and down. As you exhale, as you inhale, take it in and up to the right. Exhale, the circle out to the left. Inhale, in and up to the right. Exhale, one more time. We're gonna just inhale up. Good, and then set that leg down. Good, nice. And give a couple of movements to your hips, just a little swirl in both directions, just to bring a little relaxation there to your spine. Extend that right leg. Just let it sit. Yeah, good. And then flex the toes inside the shoe. Squeeze, hold, keep squeezing. Squeeze a little tighter. Good. And then spread, flex as best you can, and then squeeze, and then spread, and one more time, squeeze, and spread. Good. Now, placing the big toe down, keeping the heel up, and watching that you don't collide with your table leg, with the chair leg, just bring the heel in. Amazingly fast. Just focus your energy and then just amazingly fast. And then set that leg down and give a little pummeling to the knee, to the hip, especially the hip on the top and the bottom of the leg. There, you can kind of reach inside there and get the lower part of your hamstring. Good, and then sweep from the toe up the foot, ankle, lower leg, knee, and hip joint, just really smoothing the leg down on all of its surfaces. Again, this is our Smriti practice, Smriti Mani practice, which is the self-possession practice, and so we're imaging the body in these exercises from top to toe. So set that leg aside, sit tall, come into the awareness of the breath, observe the body, Kaya, energetic, conscious, self-possessed, having eliminated both desire and aversion for the world. And now, opening your eyes, bring your awareness into your left leg and straighten it out. And flex, draw back, flex, draw back, more time, flex, draw back, and then squeeze those toes, really make a fist really tight, squeeze a little bit more, and then open the toes and flex the sole of the foot and squeeze again. Squeeze as best you can. And then open. And then squeeze again. Just the base of the big toe down, keeping the heel up and being very much aware of the path that your heel is going to travel. Just bring it in as quick as you can. Ow. Gotta watch out for that. I'm sitting up. Wow, I really got up high there. Okay, so the pathway, just watch that you don't bruise yourself. Good. Okay. That's good. And then just give a pat down from the knee to the hip. And sweep from the toes and the foot up past the ankle, lower leg, knee, and the hip. Once again, just integrating that limb as well. And after you've done four or five passes or so, you just set that leg aside. Good, so we're always doing the massage from the peripheral parts of our bodies, from our fingertips, from our toes, in towards the midline to help with the lymph drainage and our overall sense of well-being. Okay, so it is time for us to finish today's